everybody. Friday, time for Cooking with Momma Drea. Today I have brought you some more tofu. We are going to be making some taco meat from our lovely tofu. So what are you going to need? One block of your natural tofu, your lovely tofu press, or your two plates with your paper towels with something heavy to press it. You're going to need kukushitni skrob or cornstarch. Soy sauce, I like, again, the light salt soy sauce, but it is up to you if you want to use the regular. Some grapeseed oil for frying. And lastly, some taco seasoning. You can make your own if you prefer. For the sake of time, I've just gone ahead and bought some. What are we gonna do first with the tofu? You guys should know this by now. We always need to press it. So we're gonna press it for 20 minutes. I'm gonna put it in the sink so it drains down into the drain, and then we're gonna come back and we're gonna get started. Let's go ahead and press our tofu. I really love this thing. Best investment ever. Okay, and we'll check back in about 20 minutes. Okay, it's been 20 minutes. My tofu has been pressed. I've gotten a small bowl. I'm gonna take my tofu and I'm gonna crumble it. Kind of like resemblance of ground beef texture. Okay, once it's crumbled, you're gonna take your kukushitni skrob or your cornstarch. You're gonna take about a teaspoon or 2 teaspoons. So one, kind of sprinkle it over, mix it up. And I'm gonna put probably another 1/2 teaspoon in there. You want it to be fully covered, not so that it's all white, but just so that you cover the top of the tofu nicely. And the cornstarch is what's gonna help so that the tofu doesn't get mushy and soggy. It's gonna create a nice crispy texture right on the outside. All right, my tofu is ready. So we're gonna move over to a frying pan. We're gonna have our soy sauce and our taco seasoning handy. And we are almost finished, so let's get frying.
Okay.
Okay, so I've got a little bit of my grapeseed oil in my pan. It's nice and hot. I'm gonna take my tofu and spread it in a nice layer, almost like you're making a pancake. So I'm gonna spread it, keep it together, and kind of press it out. You're gonna fry it on each side for, depends on how hot your frying pan is, a couple minutes until it gets goldenish, and then you're gonna flip it and do the same to the other side. And that's it, it's done. You can now put it in a taco or on some nachos or in a burrito, anything you would like for your Mexican feast without meat. If you're not in the mood for nachos and you want something else, why don't you make yourself a tortilla or maybe a taco? You can add to it anything you want. Today I'm just going with guacamole, salsa, a little bit of extra coriander, and my taco meat. You can add your sour cream, you can add refried beans, you can add cheese, anything you want. So let's get making a lovely yummy tortilla. I'm gonna start with my guacamole, kind of smash that into the bottom. I love delicious guacamole. Next I'm gonna take my meat. That color is really amazing, and I have fed this to a lot of my meat eater friends and they absolutely love it. So a little bit of my meat. And lastly, I'm gonna put my salsa on top. Ooh, and a little sprig of fresh coriander. Ooh, look at that. So yummy. Oh my goodness. I'm so excited, guys. I hope you enjoy your taco meat. Dobro huj! Give it a try. So good. See you next week.